Right students, the next concept is sustainable management. Sustainable management means all the resources, whether it is renewable or non-renewable, we have to use it. We should make use of it, without which we cannot survive. But we can use it in a sustainable way, that is in a judicious way. See, there is one concept called as JFM. JFM stands for Joint Forest Management. In the year 1972, in West Bengal, in a particular forest where lots of salt trees were grown, salt trees were there, and the villagers who were living there, they make use of these, they used to make use of these trees. They used to cut the forest and cut the branches, and they used to make use of this. But the forest department wanted to take charge of that, okay, and they wanted to remove these people out of the area, and always there is to occur clashes. Now what happened? An able and efficient officer from forest department, his name is A.K. Banerjee. A.K. Banerjee, he introduced a technique there, that is called a joint forest management. What he did, he convinced those villagers and asked them to protect the forest, asked them to use the forest in a sustainable manner, and they involved in this. In turn, what they got? The product of the forest. Okay, the products of the forest were distributed among them, maybe for a reasonable price. Then they got job opportunity, employment in silviculture and other activities related to forest. So, in one place, the forest regained its old luxury, old glory. At the same time, villagers got their livelihood. This type of management is joint forest management, which is an excellent example for sustainable management. Then coming to water, we know that monsoon pattern is not good in India, and sometimes there will be heavy monsoon, sometimes there will not be. So what is our responsibility? To collect the water, and we started to construct dams. We started to construct dams. Of course, dams are constructed for the betterment of people, but there are many problems related to that. Which are the problem? First problem, social problems. Social problem means, see, whenever we want to construct a dam, a large area of people should be shifted to another place, and they should be provided with some employment. This is social problem. Second problem, economic problem related to financial problem. To construct a dam, lots and lots or huge amount of money is required, but in turn what the benefit we get will never match. Third one, very important, environmental problem. What is that environmental problem? When a dam is constructed, a large area of forest and huge biodiversity is going to get immersed, and these are the problems related to dams. Now what we have to do? We have to go for water harvesting, maybe rainwater harvesting. We have to collect the water. We can make pits here and there, ponds, lakes. Okay, and we can collect the rainwater. The rainwater which falls on roof can be collected and can be stored. Even it can be made to enter into the ground, and we can go for recharging of groundwater. What a fine concept it is, recharging of groundwater. That is water harvesting. Then coal and petroleum, these are fossil fuels. One or the other day it's going to vanish, it's going to exhaust. So we are totally dependent on that. Our industries are dependent on that. Okay, but we have to use it in a judicious way. Moreover, they cause pollution, greenhouse effect, and so many things. Okay, health issues due to the liberation of carbon monoxide. That's why we should use it in a better way, in a judicious way. So all these concepts suggest that whatever resources we have, limited or unlimited, we should use it, we have to use it, we cannot stay without using that, but at the same time, we should use it in a judicious way so that it can be conserved for our future generation also. And That's all about the thing or the content in the chapter of Management of Natural Resources. Thank you.